God bless you, Sister Evangelist. I'm just gonna say hello to everybody in America right here. I'll be eating this piece of pizza right here. You want some? Enjoy, because this year's gonna be gone. Is it gonna come a new year, right? It's just only a couple of days and this year's gonna be gone. So I'll be eating this pizza right here. You want a piece? I wanna know who was so happy about this year. How many things this year bring it to you? Can you tell me? Tell me. It was a good year for you? Because, you know, for a lot of people in America, it was a good year, right? But thank God that you are alive, right, about this year. And you want to receive another year. What a change? Only a number, right? Only a number, because everything is going to stay in the same way. Nothing going to change, right? You're going to say. So, we're going to see this going to come. A new year, and everybody gonna celebrate. Say, Happy New Year! Like we always say, I'll be eating this slice of pizza. You want some? Very funny slice of pizza, right? You like it? So, it's gonna come another year, but it's gonna come with a lot of blessings. You know that? We see so many people inside the church, they're not focused about the message or nothing like that, because they're always inside the telephone, the whole time, focused on the telephone, and they're not even want to hear the message and nothing like that. And the pastors continue to preach the word of God, and nobody pay no mind. Why? Because people, they focus only on the phone. They love so much this item with all heart, right? And they still go to the bathroom, go with their phone. So they go to sitting down with the bench, be with the phone. So they go to the iTunes, they go with the phone. What is the problem with you with technology? People, they get crazy. They not communicate with the Lord. The whole time communicate with this item right here in the hand. You thinking like that, you ain't gonna go to heaven? You thinking God had a phone upstairs? No, that not. He don't have this kind of phone upstairs, because it's material. And you love material things, right? We see that in a lot of church around America. And then you're gonna receive the new year with your phone. I see so many people like this in the street, in every place. And not only the one is not Christian. I see the Christian one inside the church, and we see in the train. All people looking the phone like that, they get like a crazy, right? And they like to spend the phone, and nobody can want to touch those phones, because they had those touch, like they had those tone chums telephone. That's what I'm talking about. The phone, they have it like a guard. And you can't even touch it, because they focus on the phone, but they not focus on God. That's what I'm saying. And that's very sad when we see things like that inside the church, when we be busy out the church. Like about this day, you be busy in the church, and you go to the church, and you see sometimes the church is empty. But when they work on this holiday, like the 21st, but you cannot make it for the 21st, and they give you the present the 23, that's they give you the present, because the 24th, a lot of people, they don't go to church, because they're going to be, it was Saturday. And you see, the church, about the days that there was, everybody has supposed to be fasting and pray, it's empty. But when they come to this holiday, if they're going to be giving so many presents and everything, the church is very full, because people come to looking if you're going to give your present to them and everything, right? If you're going to give your present. And you be so full, the church and everything, everybody, they enjoy the Christmas inside the church. But when the holidays finish, nobody go to church. It happened like that, right? It's the same thing what happened in church and every place that you go, right? You know why? Because people, they not serving God with all heart, with all spirit. They're serving God because they selfish in everything, because they looking for material thing. Like I'm telling you, people, they focus only in this material and forms. And you will see so many people in church focusing on the form, and they don't even know what the preacher is talking about and what he's saying in the front, why he's talking about the word of God. That's very sad when we see that. They don't have no, and they don't have no, like I said, no manners and nothing like that. When you go to those church, you see those people be passing like this to the front and everything. They don't care this who is be preaching in the front, and they don't care about nothing. Everybody do whatever they want in the church, and they don't have no, they not be so polite with nobody. Why? Because they don't have no love of God inside the heart, right? And we focus only in this majority in forms and the tablets and everything, but not focus in the word of God. We see that? Did not see that in church? We see that a lot. and every church we're going, we see the same thing. Nothing gonna change, because people are gonna continue doing the same thing. Every year they come, they're gonna change only a number, like I'm telling you. When they come the new year, what happened? I'm gonna have, it's gonna come my birthday, and I'm gonna celebrate, because this year I'm gonna know. I need to celebrate no birthday. Nobody giving nothing to me. I'm not being mad because they don't give nothing to me. Even my family, they didn't even bring me no present. They don't give me no, they don't celebrate and tell me happy birthday, nothing like that. Because we see a lot of people, they like that. Even the brothers and sisters from church, they didn't even celebrate your birthday. It's not true. Because it's a pastor in the church that I'm going to, and he celebrates the birthday to everybody in church, but when I be going to church, he didn't even tell me happy birthday. You know why? Because he don't have no love for God either. Even the pastor, even the congregation, nobody in there had a love. You know what? Because when you had a love for God, and you go to church, they say, surprise! Look, this is your birthday. Or they call you, or they're looking for you, or they say your poker in the mailbox. It's not true. But people, they don't have no love for this day like that in church. And even your own family, sometimes they forgot about your birthday, right? And we got a lot of material things. We see a lot of people, then you see when they come Christmas, and you be needing a computer. I needed a computer, like a Apple computer. Who gonna give me that kind of present to this lady? Nobody, because nobody had that joy of Christmas inside their heart and say, listen, God touched my heart to give you this present. You know why? Because it's gonna cost you like $1,000. You don't wanna spend so much money to a lady like me and give you that present to that lady, right? And we see some people in church, they're so selfish. We see a lot of pastors and ladies inside the church, they didn't have the love of God. When you go to church, they didn't even give you a poker with the blessing of God inside. Nothing like that. Why? Because they don't let God touch your heart. Sometimes God touch your heart, but you don't want to do nothing about it because you don't want to show the love of God to that person. It's like, for this year, who's gonna come to the presidential? The Donald Trump, right? And a lot of people want to change for America. And you thinking Donald Trump gonna give a change to you? You be sure. And you say, no, it's coming to my church, sitting down in the bench and everything, be blessed in the name of Jesus. Let me tell you something. He's the president of the United States of America. When he come to your church, you're going to give you the first seat in the church. Why? Because he's the president. And you say, oh my God, something big, somebody with a lot of money. I want to sit down right here in my church. And everybody going to know that the president visits this church. And they're going to be a memory and a history for the whole world, right? And that's why you open the door and he's coming to your church and sitting down there. But not me. He's going to be, like I said, a Christian person. No, never in the whole life. How a rich person with a lot of money, the most rich person in America, like this president, is kind of like the Christian the Christian church. No, get out of here. Ain't gonna be like that. And when we explain this in the internet, and we're telling you the same thing every time when I go on internet, inside the internet, tell you, listen, this guy is not a Christian. He's only joking around like he's a Christian inside the church. You're gonna tell me, no, he's serving God. He's Christian. God touch your heart, and we pray for him, and he's going to change everything. When he comes to the presidential, he says he's going to give you so many jobs and everything. Everything going to change in America. You sure about that? So pride is going to come when he be in the presidential. It's gonna, they're going to start at the 20th of January, and you're going to see how they're going to change. Put everything in difficult places, and you're going to say, what the hell is wrong with this man? They say he's going to change everything. Every time when somebody want to be in the top, he's going to say a lot of things, and he's going to promise so many things, but he ain't going to make it. You know why? Because that person, he only want to be in the presidential. That's the only thing he want to be. If we see that song too much the whole time. We see that this one is going to be gone. Obama's going to get out from the White House, and this one to go inside to the White House, right? And then it's gonna be everything the same way, nothing gonna change. They are, you think America and everybody gonna have a job and everything, and they're gonna be something different. The homeless gonna have her own places and stuff like that. Get out of here. You just only talk, but no, nothing gonna make it. You know why? Because the only one promises and they gave it to you is only God, but not the president when they come to the presidential. That's a liar. Yeah, I explained to you this in the internet. It happened when you, like, when you come to church And a lot of people promise to you a lot of things and everything like that. When you go to there, they forgot what they promised to you because they lied to you. And they say, we're going to go to heaven. You're sure you're going to go to heaven. You're going to go to the lake of fire. You know why? Because you lie too much. And we see people lie too much. And well, that's what she never make it. How it was this year for you? God give you a lot of blessings to you, right? And you be blessed so many times. And why you give it to God? Nothing. When they finish this year, a lot of people are going to be not in church because not a lot of people, they don't celebrate the Happy New Year inside the church. Sometimes they stay home and waiting for the year. Or sometimes they go to Times Square waiting for that apple coming down and celebrate the Happy New Year over there. And we see that a lot. And here in America, a lot of people coming from a lot of country and come right here to New York City because this New York City is the more popular places that people they like to come because a lot of people they like to live right here in New York City because it's very popular, right? We see that a lot. We see, I live in here, that's what I'm talking about. And when I told you this thing right here in the internet, this is true, this is not a lie. This year, God bless me well, her blessing and everything, not with a lot of material things because I don't have it, but thank God I'm alive. That's what I'm saying. Because for why you want so many material things and when you don't have no life and you don't be healed and nothing like that, you, for what the hell you want maturity? Maturity, that person right here in this earth, but your life is something good that God gave it to you, right? And you have to be blessed that God give you that life. And so a lot of people, they don't be blessed. And then sometimes when you have your family, you see your family come to your home and everything, they don't bring you nothing to you. You be complaining, why you didn't bring you nothing? Why you don't give me my present, stuff like that? Why you want a present for somebody that they even bring something on her heart? They bring that because they be angry, or because they has to be, like I say, they had to only something to bring it to you. And not get out of here. Your only thing you need to have in your heart is be blessing about God, because you be alive in this earth is because of the blessing of God. It's not true. It's a lot of people, they not then the Lord, that he's here because God wants you to be here. And that's a good blessing that you never had in your whole life. And let me tell you something, be together with your own family, because a lot of people, they be at home family. And sometimes you be together with your husband, or sometimes where you be with your boyfriend, and you have to be thank God, because that is something good that happened in your life. And that's true. About this year, a lot of things go happen. A lot of people pass away. A lot of singing people, they pass away. That was very sad, because we see so many people, they pass away about this year. And you know, a lot of memories, they're going to stay about the 2016. Every time the 2016 come and everything, and they be this year, a lot of things happen, right? They come 2017. I wish that this 2017 come with a lot of blessing. People come and with a lot of peace and everything, because we see a lot of people. It doesn't matter what, how many years they come, because only they change a number, like I always telling you right here in this internet. And we say so many people, they not be satisfied for nothing. Because every time when God bring give you another year, they're not satisfied. Satisfied that you be alive. It's not something good in your life. So thank God about another day he gave it to you, to me, to everybody in America. We see a lot of people, they pass away in the 2016. And it was very sad. Let me tell you something. We see a lot of people pass away. So many people. And every year they come, you have to be blessing with the love of God inside your heart. You know why I always mention my God? Because I know every time that you're standing up from that bed, you have to tell God, thank you for another day you gave it to me. And thank you because I'll be alive. A lot of people, they say, nah, I'll be alive because I got, let me tell you something. The one who gave your life to you is God. And you will not be have that life because you're a human person. And when God tell you, stop, and you're going to keep living this earth, they take you away. But God give you the life, and you're supposed to thank God for the life you got. And we see a lot of people, they don't thank God. That's what I say.